science is about exploration. The bar that we have to jump over is to find new things about nature that no one ever knew before. Ideally, we'd really like to find the microbes that are living deep in the earth and getting expelled when the water rushes past them. That's really what we'd love to see. But we are also interested in that interface. What happens when this deep subterranean fluids that have never seen the light of day come to the surface? Most of the work that's been done on microbiology in hot springs has been done in Yellowstone National Park, which is a completely different system. Here we have a subduction zone where the oceanic plate is getting shoved underneath the continental plate, and that creates a different chemical and physical environment for the microbes. Let's get the white from that, and let's get the orange from there.
Okay.
My interest in these very strange microbes comes from the fact that I would like to know how all of life interconnects. This is totally different from anything that we've seen so far in Costa Rica, so we're kind of excited to find out what it is. I am a little nervous about going into Poas, just because I've heard it's a tough climb down.
The biggest risks are probably loose boulders on your way down. So the initial ascent is steep in places.
The climb doesn't bother me so much. That sounds like fun. But I would like for it to not erupt. That's like really got my fingers crossed.
Poas is an active volcano. It's one of the most extreme environments on Earth.
Right next to this acid lake with like a few hundred degrees of acid gases coming right out of the ground.
pH goes from 0 to 1. It means pure acid.
Man, that's strong. We're modern day explorers. There's so much that we don't know. We have so much work left to do.